This video will discuss how we estimate the allowance using the percentage of receivables method. Under the allowance method, companies must estimate the allowance to record bad debt expense. Two bases are used to determine this amount. The first is the percentage of sales, and the second is percentage of receivables. Both bases are generally accepted. We will focus on the percentage of receivables. Under the percentage of receivables basis, management estimates what percentage of receivables will result in losses from uncollectible accounts. The company establishes a percentage relationship between receivables and expected losses from uncollectible accounts. The amount of the estimated allowance or bad debt expense that should be recorded is the amount needed to get to the required balance. You simply compare the required balance to the existing balance in the allowance account. The company prepares an aging schedule, which classifies customer balances by the length of time they have been unpaid. Because of its emphasis on time, the analysis is often called aging the accounts receivable. After the company arranges the accounts by age, it determines the expected bad debt losses. It applies percentages based on past experiences to the totals in each category. As I just stated, the aging of accounts receivable schedule classifies customer balances by the length of time they have been unpaid. In this example, accounts receivable totals $39,600. Of this amount, $27,000 are not due yet, $5,700 are 1 to 30 days past due, $3,000 are 31 to 60 days past due, and then $2,000 are 61 to 90 days, and then lastly, $1,900 are over 90 days past due. After the company arranges the accounts by age, it determines the estimated percentage uncollectible or bad debt loss rate. This is based on past experiences. The longer a receivable is past due, the less likely it is to be collected. As a result, the rate increases as the number of days past due increases. So in this example, the rate increases from 2 to 40%. To determine the estimated uncollectible amounts, we simply multiply the totals of each category by the bad debt loss rate. Total estimated uncollectible accounts for this company is $2,228. This represents the amount of existing customer accounts that are expected to become uncollectible in the future. It also represents the required balance in the allowance for doubtful accounts. If the unadjusted trial balance shows allowance for doubtful accounts with a credit balance of $528, that represents the existing balance, and the aging schedule estimated the uncollectibles to be $2,228, then an adjusting entry for $1,700, which is the difference between the required and the existing balance. It would result in a debit to bad debt expense and a credit to the allowance for doubtful accounts in the amount of $1,700. The allowance account may have a debit balance prior to the adjustment. This occurs when the write-offs during the year exceeded the previous estimates for bad debt. In this instance, the company adds the debit balance to the required balance when it makes the adjusting entry. For example, if there was a $500 debit balance in the allowance account before adjustment and the required balance is $2,228, the adjustment would be for $2,728, which is the sum of the existing balance of $500 plus the required balance of $2,228. This would result in the following journal entry: a debit to bad debt expense and a credit to allowance for doubtful accounts in the amount of $2,728.